Hi there. I'm going to show you how to decorate a candle today. I've got some candles here that I decorated with Crafty Individuals stamps. This one is the lovely kingfisher. Then here we've got the beautiful balloon. And then I've also got the stag. Hope you can see those okay. I'm experimenting with new technology, so you'll have to excuse me if it doesn't go according to plan. Okay. Right, so first of all, I've got a candle here. They sell them in Tesco's, IKEA, Wilko's, all those sorts of shops. Just a plain, straightforward pillar candle that I'm going to put one of the new, exciting Crafty Individual stamps on. Okay, so as you can see, I've got a just plain white tile. I tend to do quite a lot of my watercolouring on one like this. First thing I'm going to do, I've got VersaFine Clair black ink, and I'm going to cover my stamp in the ink. Okay, then I'm going to take the tissue. This is a piece of ordinary tissue paper. Most tissue paper, there's a shiny side and there's a dull side. I've tried it with both, doesn't really matter which way up you put it. Okay, and then I'm going to lay that tissue paper on top of the ink stamp, and you see the design come through. Just smooth your finger over it. And that way you'll know that all of the design's been picked out onto your tissue, and then you can lift it off. Okay. I normally give that a few minutes to dry, at least. So because of that, here's one I did earlier. And what I'm going to do is just put a little bit of masking tape, or stencil tape, this is actually, at the top and at the bottom, just to keep it flat while I'm colouring it. Okay, so, oops, excuse me. Right, I'm going to use my Kohinoor watercolours, and I've selected this particular palette, and I'll show you the colours. These are the colours on this particular palette. Because the Kohinoors are so intense in colour, you tend to find that they're quite dark looking. So it's difficult to tell exactly what colour it is. But I've done a little swatch for each set so that I know what to use. Okay, I'm going to use the purple today. The reason that I do it on a white tile, a lot of the glass mats have a hint of colour about them, and if you want to see exactly what the colour's like, you can just paint a little bit onto your white tile and then wipe it off again afterwards. Okay, so I'm going to go in this beautiful camper van stamp with purple paint. Okay. So I'm just painting the top and the main body of the camper van. Now, don't worry too much if the paint goes off this edge, because you're going to cut it out, so you can cut it fairly close to the with an image like this, it's pretty easy to cut and lose that little spill over the edge. But if you try and keep your brush nice and not too wet, you should get a nice intense colour, but not spread any further than you want it to. I suppose that's one of the downsides of using your tile as your background, because the water will spread. You could put it onto paper, and then the paper would soak up the excess, but I don't know, I just find it's easier to move the colour about without tearing the paper, without tearing the tissue paper, if you've got it secured to a tile. But you know, it's whatever you feel comfortable working with, really. It's not a right, there's not a right way or a wrong way, as with most craft things. Right, I'm moving it slightly so I don't go and put my hand in it. There we go. So, because the Kohinoor paints are so full of pigment, you can use them for all sorts of things. You can make great backgrounds with them. I know Jean has done some Crafty Individuals Facebook Lives that have used these to do some fabulous backgrounds. They're also great for using as watercolour paints. There we go. Right, so I've got a little bit of a splodge there, but that's okay because I can cut that off. And I'm also going to go into this middle bit of the bumper, just down the bottom here. That's fine. Right, while I've got this palette out, I'm going to take a bit of the blue, which is next to the purple, and water it down a little bit more. And then I'll go into the windows. Certainly at the moment, sky has been so blue, it has looked rather like the colour on these windows. Oops, I've gone over the edge again there, but like I say, it's the outer edge, so I can cut it off. I'm not worried about it. Okay, and I think this time I'm going to go in with purple again and do the sign, VW sign on the front of the van. VW vans, I've got special memories of these. My dad's friend, who I called Uncle Eric, had many camper vans over the years, and he used to go with my dad and John, another friend, and they used to go to the Lake District. They used to go for a few days and do silly things like fall asleep on the top of mountains and come back very sunburnt. But they absolutely loved it, and The three of them would have a few days out camping and living in the camper van. And it seemed to always be the Lake District. They were all teachers, and they used to take parties of kids camping in the Lake District. And they used to go and check out walks and places to take them before they went, so that was their excuse anyway. But I think, the camper vans hold a special place in our hearts because Dad used to love it. If you're not already a member of the Crafty Individuals Facebook group, then please do go and come and join us, because we've got a lovely, supportive, friendly group who use Crafty Individuals products and make some amazing creations. And it's a lovely, friendly, supportive community. So have a look for us on Facebook. Okay. Right, I think I'll do the indicators next. So some bright orange for this. We go. And then let's look. I'll just give the headlights a little touch of yellow. There we go. Right. Now on to the tyres. So I'll try the one of the black or dark grey ones for this. Well, that is quite dark, but I think it'd be all right. Then I think for the rest of it, I've got the Cosmic Shimmer. These are I think it's the metallic set. Let's have a look. Yes, set one metallics. They're iridescent shimmering watercolor paints. So I'm going to use this silver one here for the chrome on the van. Okay. Yeah. I've gone a little bit over the edge there, but I shall touch it up with some purple in a second. You can probably see I am not the best at watercolouring on tissue paper, but it's a nice effect in the end, so it doesn't matter if you make the odd mistake here and there. I think I've learned that more and more over the years. It's like what you can cover up with something else or you can go in and sort out with a wet brush or a bit more colour. It's amazing what you can do to rescue things. Okay. Right. A quick look. I normally have a good look at things like this because I'm a devil for doing things quickly and then suddenly discovering I haven't painted that bit. Right, so I'm just going to give a tiny bit of that yellow rub over the number plate. Okay, so you've probably seen there how I've used my tile as a palette, and I can go back in and get a bit of one colour or another and just touch bits up. And normally I'd spend quite, you know, a while on this, or and probably let, to be honest, let it dry between each colour. But I'm reasonably happy with that. So just need to make sure it's dry. That's feeling okay. So I'm going to peel off the tape. And then I'm going to cut it out. Okay. Right, by taping it down, you can see that there's paint there on my palette. But by taping it down, it means you don't move it, and then you don't get so many smudges as you would do if it was just loose. Okay, so my little scissors are here on my craft table tonight. There they are. So I'm just going to trim relatively close to the camper van. Now, where there's no spills over the edges, that's absolutely fine, and you can leave a border and it doesn't, that's going to disappear into the candle wax. Okay, where you have gone over the edge, you'll need to cut a little bit closer, like just here on this side. I'm just going to trim very carefully along that edge there. And here, because it's not quite, I'm going to trim close to, there we go. But then around the other bits, you'll see I'm not being quite so careful. Now, if you're doing something like the Kingfisher stamp, where you've got the bits of foliage around the bottom, you can just cut and leave quite a decent sized border around those. It's not a problem at all, because like I say, the tissue paper just goes into the surface of the candle. Right, so there we go, there's our camper van ready to go onto the candle. So this is the next bit. Let me move that palette out of the way, actually. So I've got my candle and I've got my camper van, and the other thing I need is a piece of greaseproof paper. Okay, so it's not the cleanest piece of greaseproof paper, but it's okay. So here we go, I've wrapped the greaseproof paper around, I've got it really tight at the back, and my image is flat onto the candle. Okay, and I'm holding it really tightly so that there's no air bubbles or anything in it, no wrinkles. And then you need a heat gun. And here's my heat gun. And you aim the heat gun at your image, and you'll slowly see the image appearing to be a little bit darker. Here we go, look. And then that's the wax melting. And then you chase the edge of it up your candle. Now it's really important that you keep your fingers out of the way, because it can get quite hot. Okay, but you can see how the image is appearing slightly stronger colours all the way across. There's bottom corner here. Okay, hope you can see that okay. Alright, and then when that's done, just maybe smooth it down a little bit, leave it for a few seconds. Oh, I can see, look, there's a little bit missing there, so I'll just go into that bit again. There we go. Sorted. Okay. And then when that's done, we just peel off the greaseproof paper. And there's the candle. Not perfectly painted, that one, but never mind. And you can actually go over it. So I've got Posca pen here. If you find that the silver isn't quite smooth, I've just noticed there's a little bit along that edge that isn't very smooth. I'd go in with my Posca pen and put a few bits on. If I show you the stag again, with this one, I've gone in with a gold pen and I've gone in with some liquid pearls and just put a few tiny spots on. Now I don't know what the flammable aspect of liquid pearls is, but I know I've burnt these candles, and as long as you don't let your tissue paper fall into the flame, you'd be absolutely fine burning it, because it'll just peel away and come out towards you, and the candle will burn down within the wax. Well, thanks for watching. All of the stamps that you've seen on the candles today came from Crafty Individuals. You can get the Kohinoor paints from Crafty Individuals too. Thanks for watching. Okay, bye.